Welcome to Understand the Math. In this video, I'm going to walk you through an example problem where we'll find the singular value decomposition of this given matrix using five easy-to-follow steps. Before we get started, you may want to download the free guided notes that go along with this video. These notes will help you follow along, highlight key concepts, and fill in important details as you watch the video. Let's start by going over the structure of a singular value decomposition of a matrix, so you'll be able to understand how to find the decomposition of the matrix we'll be working with, as well as any other matrix that you may encounter. We'll let matrix A be the matrix that we want to find the decomposition of, and it can be any m by n matrix, and it has a rank of r. The singular value decomposition of matrix A is equal to matrix U times matrix sigma times the transpose of matrix V. When finding the singular value decomposition of a matrix, the first matrix that you need to find is matrix sigma. Sigma is an m by n diagonal matrix. It's the same size as matrix A, and it represents a scaling transformation. Entries along the diagonal of the matrix are sigma 1, sigma 2, all the way up to sigma r. These values are called singular values, and they're positive. Sigma sub I is the square root of lambda sub I, where lambda sub I is the non-zero eigenvalues of A transpose A and A transpose. These two matrices are symmetric matrices, and they have the same non-zero eigenvalues. If matrix A has more rows than columns, our matrix sigma contains a diagonal matrix and then m minus r extra rows of zero. If matrix A has more columns than rows, then m is less than n, and sigma contains a diagonal matrix and then n minus r extra columns of zero. If matrix A is square, then sigma will contain the diagonal matrix D and then m minus r extra rows of zero and n minus r extra columns of zero. The second matrix that you need to find in a singular value decomposition is matrix V. Matrix V is a square n by n orthogonal matrix, and it represents a rotation or reflection transformation. The column vectors of matrix V are orthonormal vectors. The first r columns of V are the normalized eigenvectors of A transpose A. These are called the right singular vectors of A. And then the last n minus r columns of V are normalized vectors that are in the null space of matrix A. The last matrix that you need to find in a singular value decomposition is matrix U. It is also a square matrix, and it is a m by m orthogonal matrix. Just like matrix V, it represents a rotation or reflection transformation. The column vectors in matrix U are orthonormal vectors, and the first r columns of U are the normalized eigenvectors of A transpose. Notice that that's different than the A transpose A we worked with to find matrix V. The last m minus r columns of U are normalized vectors that are in the null space of A transpose. In practice, it's easier to find the vectors in matrix U from the vectors that we already found in matrix V. To do that, we're going to use our decomposition, and then we're going to multiply each side of the equation by vector V, and this gives us that AV is equal to U times sigma, because V transpose V is the identity, because V is an orthogonal matrix. This gives us the formula AVI is equal to sigma UVI, and then we can easily find our UVI, which is our column vectors in matrix U, from this equation. Now that we understand the structure of our decomposition, we're ready to find the SVD of the matrix in our example problem. The first step that we need to complete is to find the sizes of each of the three matrices and the rank of A. We'll let the matrix in our example be equal to matrix A, and we'll decompose it into U, sigma, and V transpose. A is a 3x2 matrix, which means U is going to be a 3x3 matrix. Remember, matrix U is square. And then sigma is the same size of A, so that's a 3x2. And then matrix V is also square, and it has to be a 2x2 matrix. Let's now find the rank of matrix A. What we're going to do is we're going to take matrix A, put it in echelon form, and then just count pivots. The echelon form of this matrix looks like this. 1, 0, 0, 1, minus 1, 0. We'll circle our pivots, and there are two of them, so we can conclude that our rank R is equal to 2. Knowing the rank helps us determine where to get the vectors for matrix U and matrix V. Our second step is to find matrix sigma. Sigma is the same size as matrix A, and it is a 3x2 diagonal matrix. Since our rank is 2, our diagonal matrix is going to look like this. The first entry is sigma 1, and then the second entry along the diagonal will be sigma 2. Our singular values sigma sub I are just the square root of lambda sub I, where lambda sub I are the non-zero eigenvalues of A transpose A. Since M is greater than N, we know that we are going to have one additional row of zeros, and that tells us that our sigma is going to look like this. Sigma 1, 0, 0, sigma 2, and then our additional row of zeros. The first thing we have to do now is to compute A transpose times A. A transpose looks like this. And then we have our matrix A. When you multiply all this out, we end up with the matrix 2, 1, 1, 2. Now that's the matrix that we're going to use to find the eigenvalues, and we'll do that next. To find the eigenvalues, we're going to take the determinant of A transpose A minus lambda I, set it equal to 0, and then find our lambda. This gives us a 2 minus lambda, a 1, a 1, a 2 minus lambda is equal to 0. This is 2 minus lambda quantity squared minus 1 is 0. And when we solve this, we end up with lambda is equal to 3 and 1. When you do singular value decomposition, you always want to make your first eigenvalue be your largest. So we're going to assign lambda 1 equal to 3, and then lambda 2 equal to 1. Now that we know lambda, we can find our sigmas. Sigma 1 is going to be the square root of 3, and then sigma 2 is the square root of 1, which is just 1. Our last step then is to just construct sigma. We already saw up above, let's look at that, what sigma looks like. So now we can just plug in. We're going to have sigma 1, which is root 3, 0, and then we have a 0 and our sigma 2, which is 1, and then our extra row of zeros. The third step that we need to complete is to find matrix V. Matrix V is a 2x2 orthogonal matrix. Let's make a note that in this example, N is equal to R, which means that our vectors in V will be just the R normalized eigenvectors of A transpose A. We'll start by finding the normalized eigenvectors of A transpose A for each lambda. We're going to find lambda from this equation. To do that, we're just going to take A transpose A minus lambda I, augment it with 0, and then put it in reduced echelon form. We're first going to find the eigenvectors that correspond to lambda 1 is equal to 3. So plugging this in, we get a 2 minus lambda, which is 2 minus 3, a 1, 1, and then a 2 minus 3, augment that with zero. And I'm going to skip a few steps. And what you end up with in reduced echelon form is 1 minus 1, 0, 0. And then we have our 0 on the right-hand side. This gives us x1 is x2. And then our vector x, which is equal to x1, x2, becomes x2 times 1, 1. I'm going to choose for x2 to be equal to 1 just to make things easy. So vector x is just 1, 1. We note that the magnitude of vector x, for when we normalize it, we're going to need this. That's going to be equal to root 2. So our normalized eigenvector is going to be v1. And it's 1 over root 2 and 1 over root 2. Now we're going to do the same thing for lambda 1 is equal to 1. So we have 2 minus 1, 1, 1, 2 minus 1, augmented with 0. Skipping steps again gives us 1, 1, 0, 0, very similar to the one right up above. And this gives us x1 is minus x2. Using the same steps that we did above, I'm going to skip a couple of them. We're going to end up with an x is equal to minus 1, 1. Note that the magnitude of this x is also equal to root 2. So our normalized vector v2 is going to be equal to minus 1 over root 2 and 1 over root 2. Now all we have to do is construct our matrix V. Our matrix V is just going to contain our vectors v1 and v2 that we just found, and we'll put them in. So our first column is 1 over root 2, 1 over root 2, and then our second column is minus 1 over root 2, and 1 over root 2. I want to point out in this note that if n is greater than r, remember, in the example that we're doing, n is equal to r, so we didn't encounter this. But in case you do, I want you to understand what you will need to do. If n is greater than r, you will need to get additional normalized eigenvectors. And these are going to come from a times x is equal to 0. And you'll get them. And then you're going to have to use the Gram-Schmidt algorithm to make them orthogonal if there's more than one of them. Hang with me, we only have two steps left to complete. Step four is to find matrix U. Our matrix U is a 3x3 orthogonal matrix, and in our example, our M is greater than R, which means that our first two vectors, that's our R normalized vectors, are going to come from this formula, and then our third vector, our M minus R, M is 3, R is 2, so M minus R is 1. So our one extra normalized vector is going to come from A transpose times X is equal to 0. Let's first find the normalized vectors U1 and U2. We're going to use this formula right there. This is a pretty easy calculation. So U1 is going to be 1 over sigma 1 times A V1. Remembering these values from our previous page, we have 1 over root 3. Our A looks like this. And then we have our V, which we just found. This gives us the vector 2 over root 6, 1 over root 6, and then another 1 over root 6. We'll do a similar calculation to find U2. This is 1 over sigma 2, AV2. This one's a little bit easier because sigma 2 is equal to 1. So we just have our matrix A times our vector V2, which is minus 1 over root 2, 1 over root 2, which gives us our vector U2, 0 minus 1 over root 2, and then 1 over root 2. I want to make a note Then since our vectors v1 and v2 were already normalized, our u's that we just found are automatically normalized. Now we're going to find our extra vector u3. This vector is going to come from A transpose times x is equal to 0. All we need to do is take A transpose, augment it with 0, and put it in reduced echelon form. I have this started for us, and I'm going to skip the steps and jump right to the reduced echelon form. We get 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, minus 1, 0, 0. So this gives us x1 is equal to minus x3, and then x2 is equal to x3. This gives us vector x. We'll pull out an x3 in front, and we have the vector minus 1, 1, 1. To make things easy, let's let x3 equal 1, and then we have our vector x equal to minus 1, 1, 1. Let's note that the magnitude of this vector is equal to the square root of 3, so we can write down that our vector u3 is equal to minus 1 over root 3, 1 over root 3, and then another 1 over root 3. I want to make a note real quick that if m is greater than r plus 1, in our case, we had m is 3, r is 2, so we didn't encounter this situation. But if m is greater than r plus 1, you're going to get additional normalized u vectors from A transpose x is equal to 0, and then you're going to have to use the Gram-Schmidt algorithm to make them orthogonal. Now that we have all three u vectors, we can construct our matrix U. Our matrix U just contains our vectors U1, U2, and U3, and it's equal to 2 over root 6, 1 over root 6, another 1 over root 6, and then a 0, minus 1 over root 2, 1 over root 2, and then in our third column, we have minus 1 over root 3, a 1 over root 3, and then another 1 over root 3. Our last step is the easiest one. All we need to do is to construct our singular value decomposition, and we've already found all three matrices that make up this composition. Our answer looks like this. For our last matrix, you just have to remember to transpose matrix V. That's going to look like 1 over root 2, minus 1 over root 2, and then 1 over root 2, and 1 over root 2. Remember that you can check your answer by multiplying out the right-hand side and making sure that it equals the left-hand side. Now that you've seen how to compute a singular value decomposition step-by-step, you have a solid foundation for applying SVD in linear algebra and in real-world applications.
If this video has been helpful to you, please consider subscribing to my channel. Keep believing in yourself and have a great rest of your day.